One more Dweller's Area with Scabbard as the track lights power up here at the fairgrounds. It's a grade two presented by Lamarck Ford Lincoln. They're in the gate. And they're off in the first division of the Risen Star Stakes. Perfect Revenge stumbled at the start. Mr. Monomoy broke sharp.
Along with Library 9 and Prince of Old is fighting their front rank as Mr. Monomoy takes the top for
football. Giroux. With the inside at long odds, ready to roll, and Blackberry Wine is right up there near the speed. Sha Sha Shake Me Up running in fourth. Digital is fifth toward the rail as Mr. Monomoy leads them to the back of the track. Silver State is next in behind horses for Ricardo Santana Jr. Scabbard is posted wide in the four path with just over six furlongs to go. Perfect Revenge. The yellow blinkers with the rail outside that moon over Miami. Then comes Farmington Road. And with Julian Laperoux, the LeCompte winner. Enforceable racing a joint last after the nine furlong start. The clear at 24.22 seconds. Mr. Monomoy, the pace is his. Mr. Monomoy leads three quarters length to Blackberry Wine. Digital is right there biding his time in third. Three quarters length to Ready to Roll in fourth. Silver State is seven from the leaders. Joined out wide by Sha Sha Shake Me Up. With inside a half mile to go. Enforceable is nine from the front and behind horses. Scabbard is wide. Perfect Revenge. Farmington Road. Moon over Miami is being driven to gain after a half mile in 48.57 seconds. They turn again. Three furlongs to go. And Blackberry Wine makes a move on Mr. Monomoy. And these two together coming toward the quarter pole. Digital is right there. Digital is gaining ground. Ready to roll. And Silver State swings into action on the far outside. And Enforceable follows Silver State into the stretch. Three quarters in 1 minute 12.85 seconds. It's Mr. Monomoy driven by by Floron Giroux. Turn back Blackberry Wine. Here's Digital, who's charging now. Silver State then on the outside. Enforceable needs to lift. They come down to the final 16th with Floron Giroux. It's Mr. Monomoy. Mr. Monomoy leads them home in the first division of the Risen Star Stakes, 1-3. Enforceable gained second. Silver State was third. Farmington Road, Digital next across from Scabbard. And then Blackberry Wine from Moon Over Miami. Ready to roll. Perfect Revenge. And Shaw Shake Me Up trailed in.
We were very, very happy with British Hitty, and the other horse had a ton of season. And, you know, this was the Rachel Alexandra way we would have liked to have won. It wasn't our ultimate objective. So we were very proud of British Hitty. And as to Monomoy Girl, I knew this horse was real. The day he debuted, he ran a really troubled fourth. I said to myself, I think I can win the Kentucky Derby with that horse. So we'll keep our fingers crossed. But, you know, it's Monomoy Girl's brother, and has the class of Monomoy Girl, and we're over the moon.
And a mile and eighth race in the middle of February for a young horse, that's encouraging.
Well, you know, the breeding is Palace Malice, so we, you know, felt this horse would go long. We never gave up hope on this horse, you know, kind of a difficult third last time, but not badly beaten, and had the feeling the horse would go forward, and he did.
What do you see this colt's strongest characteristic?
Determination and class. I think he can overcome adversity. I don't think he has to have the lead. I don't think he wants to necessarily be way back, but I think the horse has class and versatility, and, you know, forwardly placed is where, you know, you want to be when there's a 20-horse field.
Right.
If you can. You're not necessarily lead, but forwardly placed.
Complete certainty that he would be a true route horse? Like, how far would he stay? Do you feel differently about that now?
Yeah, I do, but I think it's given the pace. You know, I mean, I think it has a lot to do with the pace and how comfortable he can be. I mean, he doesn't have to be on the lead, I don't think, to get him to the wire first. But, you know, I think given the pace, I mean, he can be a factor, you know, mile and eighth and beyond.
What does this race mean for this colt today, especially coming up?
It's big. This big. It's a grade two win for a horse that's, you know, now on the Derby trail. And, you know, he's got some pedigree now. I mean, he's a half to a champion and a multiple Grade One winners. So, you know, it's big for him, and it's a big update for him and the family. And, you know, we'll see what happens moving forward. You know, we'll get together with the owners and, you know, come up with a plan. And, you know, if all's well, you know, it'd be one spot and then Derby, one race, and then hopefully onto the Derby.
With the horses in this race, the colts in this race, him going to the lead, you were not concerned about it being run down at all?
Well, yeah, it's always a concern, but I mean, you know, they couldn't get him today. that's all that matters.
That's what's important.
But how much when you look ahead to the Derby and the fact that he's already won at a mile and eighth, usually you don't know that till late March.
No, that's very true. And honestly, when I opened the condition book to begin the season, I saw Risen Star mile and eighth, Louisiana Derby, mile and 3/16. I thought it would kill it. And I gave Scott Jones credit the other day. I said, dude, you got 23 entries for something that's, you know, new. So obviously it was a good thing for the fairgrounds to increase the distance, and, you know, obviously we're pleased with it.
To the Louisiana Derby necessarily?
I don't know. I mean,
it falls in as usual. I mean, it always falls in a kind of awkward spot, being that far out. So
I think it's 5 weeks to the Risen Star, or
from here to there,
and then 6 weeks. I like the timing. I like how that sounds. But once again, I'll talk to these guys.
Oh, you do? You wouldn't mind the 6 week, just wait.
I wouldn't personally, no. I mean, I know, you know, there's been a lot of horses come out of a few horses do the three week turnaround from Arkansas Derby to Kentucky Derby. But listen, the bottom line is you gotta have a horse that's doing really well and get a good trip in the Derby. So.
But what about the mile 3/16? Even though it is 6 weeks out, is that something that is that a plus, or is that something that might be asking young horses?
I'm okay with it. I mean, you know, I kind of thought a mile and an eighth in February was a question mark, but you know, it worked out for us, so you know, I think we'll be okay at a mile 3/16 if that's what we choose to do.
He drew inside, and there was a couple of speed horses outside of me, and I was not unable to go down lead, but I didn't want to go too fast also too, and that was a pretty decent trip, but you know, I had to slam on the brake, you know, a few times. I never got blocked, but I got through a little bit late, you know, last time. But no, worked out great today, you know. He has a great tactical speed, so I used it. And if somebody wanted to go faster than me, you know, I probably would have let them go. But when no one took it, I just took advantage of it.
You rode Monomoy, a girl, yeah. Obviously, right?
Yeah.
Half sister, different sires. But does he remind you at all of her?
No, nothing. No, I mean, he kind of built a little bit the same, you know, very muscular, a little bit bulky, you know, look like almost like sprinters. But no, I mean, they did different mind. I mean, she's definitely on her own leagues. I mean, she's not the sweetest filly, you know. She can run a lot, but she's very mean, and probably it works for her, you know, because probably well, she gets her attitude, and maybe she wants to be the best too, you know. But they're different horses. He's very kind horse and very sweet and gentle.
This horse.
Yes.
Yeah. Mile and eighth in mid-February. Well, you've got to be happy about the way.
Yeah, no, exactly. No, it went good. You know, always, you know, thinking about, you know, distance, as the everybody's thinking, can he go a little bit farther? You know, he went mile eight right now. It's by Palace Malice, you know, who won the Belmont Stakes. We thought, you know, Miss Monomoy Girl was not going too far, and she won three grade one going a mile eight. So, you know, we can dream with this guy, hopefully.